The button has been pressed. Hello, happy people. And I have some amazing news. I did it. I got vaccinated against COVID-19 with the Sputnik vaccine. And in this vlog, I'm going to tell you all about it. But before I will tell you my opinion and what I think, I have filmed some videos during my second shot. At first, the doctor didn't allow me to film it. Then I asked her why. We had a conversation and then she said that I'm allowed to film. So here you go. Here is the whole process.
Here I'm about to get my second shot. And here are the people that came. Some of them wear masks below their noses. Kind of don't make sense.
Yeah. И там нужно что-то с паспортами, понимаете, вносить данные. Вы здесь какая, вот здесь прививочка, на новый, наверное, уже вы делали, а там, может быть, старые какие-то у вас еще.
Ой, прям такой добрый.
Так, вы на первую? Вы свои данные проверяете вот здесь точно, так записано, дата рождения, Надя.
Сейчас масло уже присаживается. Нет, снимать нельзя.
А можно снять?
Нет, нельзя.
Почему?
Нет, мне разрешают.
I was not allowed to film how I'm being vaccinated second time. I don't know why, but that's the reality.
Ну хорошо, да, нужно.
Так, все, делаем вторую.
Давайте, как первую? Первую, у меня была температура 37,2, 37,3 где-то, ну то есть такая, не сильно. Вторую обычно хуже люди приносят.
Смотри, все хорошо приносят. Вот с красненькой, видишь, тебе красненькое делают? Да. Это вторая тебе.
Вон люди, которые сейчас пришли, говорят, вообще ничего не чувствовали. Но у меня была температура.
Мы уже 2000 людей прибили. Да. Прошу меня, спросите, кто как. Еще ни один не умер. У некоторых было под 40, ничего страшного. Ребята делали, некоторые даже от температуры не пили. А некоторые парацетамольчик.
Пили, да? Ну. А руку то же самое, левую?
Все, как вы хотите, все равно.
Ну вот левая у меня уже.
Давайте. Три дня вместо прививки мочалкой не трем. Может появиться температурка, держите, может держите. Всё? Да, держите, это пока приклеим.
Быстро так.
Вот сделано, видите?
Да.
Сейчас руку не приклеим, не уходите. Мы с лейкопластырем с этим не спим.
Я поняла. Снимать через пару часов?
Да, подождите. Держите пальчиком, это сухая. Держите. Лейкопластырь на язык не приклеивается. Бросила. Все?
Угу.
Также три дня места не приклеиваем. Вместо мочалкой не трем, спиртные напитки не употребляем. 21 день также пока с масочкой ходите.
Я потому поняла, что, да. Там не гарантируют.
Не тоже не гарантируют. Вы еще нет, не вы не заразны. Вам же еще на 21 день ввели им этот, антитела.
Продержаться, чтобы они были.
Конечно, вы еще пока слабенькие. Не вы заразные, просто вы еще пока не.
Да.
Все,
я поняла.
Before I traveled to Russia, I knew it's going to be not an easy trip to make because living in Europe now, I have a very different understanding of COVID. And speaking to my family, seeing how people clubbing in Russia, going out, just, you know, living their normal life, that made me feel very uncomfortable. But I haven't been home for more than a year and it's been way too long. I just wanted to see my family. And this idea of the vaccination came back then. I saw the information about the vaccine Sputnik in the international magazine called Lancet. It's a respectable scientific magazine, and that's what kind of persuaded me to go for it. I still don't know if it was the right or the wrong choice. Like I said, I'm not pro-vaccine. But I know that the COVID is dangerous. I don't want to get it. I don't want to see what it does to my body. Because when people say, what will the vaccine will do to me? But do you know what COVID will do to you? I mean, it is a dangerous disease. And I'm not a scientist to make any conclusions about it. And since I went for like the whole year following the rules, doing everything right, I didn't get sick once. Maybe I was lucky. Maybe it actually helped that I didn't even have any flu. who knows, maybe it's my immunity system, but I do see a certain correlation that with the fact that I was careful, that I didn't get COVID, and I just wanted to keep going like that. I didn't want to suddenly get it. And the first shock came when I was taking a flight from Madrid to Moscow. And on the flight, I took a flight with Aeroflot. There were already people who didn't have the masks on. The flight attendants weren't following the regulations. I understand it's hard to go and check with everyone, but a lot of flight attendants would have their masks like here below their nose, which of course doesn't help. And I remember I tried to take a seat like at the very end of the plane, and there was a woman who sat in the parallel row to mine, and her mask was like here, and that made me very uncomfortable. So I approached her, she was Russian, I said, please, can you put your mask on? And she said, why don't you mind your own business? And, you know, that's when I realized it's going to be really tough, that I'm not gonna get my way with people who just follow the norms. I mean, in Europe, it's also not perfect. But here in Madrid, where I live right now, you might see one person in 100 who doesn't wear a mask. And you can approach them, you can ask them, please, can you put your mask on? And usually it should be fine. So when I arrived in Moscow, it was just hundreds of people in Sheremetyevo Airport, not wearing any masks. And I knew that there would be people who wouldn't wear masks, but I didn't imagine that it would be to this extent. And that really shocked me. It all really started in Moscow. I realized the situation. It felt like you were in the middle of zombie apocalypse, and all the people without the masks are zombies, and you're the only one that's wearing a mask. And you try to fight them, you try to do something, but at some point you just realize it's beyond your powers. Like, you can't do anything. There are way too many people who come up with different reasoning. And what's interesting, I found different categories of Russian people and what they would tell me when I would politely ask them to put the masks on. The first category are the people who say COVID doesn't exist. Like, they're scientists, they know better, they tell me it's all a fairy tale. And usually there is a very strong link to the government or to being opposed to politics. I'm not going to comment anything about the politics. Obviously, I have my views, but I can understand these people in a certain way. But also, I do believe that there are conspiracy theories about everything. And actually, why would government be interested to create a bad vaccine? Like, it's possible. It's possible there are things we still don't know about the vaccine, of course. That's why I'm not making anyone else doing it. I just made this decision for myself. But why? Why would they want you to feel bad afterwards? I do believe that, interestingly enough, despite the situation in Russia with everything else, we do have some good scientists and doctors, very talented people who are still capable of creating something decent. So that's why I did it. That's where all my hope went. The second category of people would tell you, look at me, I look great, I'm healthy, there is nothing wrong with me. So I would have to talk to them about being asymptomatic and still having COVID. I have friends who had COVID and they didn't have any symptoms, and they checked their antibodies were super high. Obviously, this wouldn't reach the people who believe that they're healthy, because they know better. And then there is one more special category of the taxi drivers. Every taxi I took in Russia, almost in every taxi, I would have to speak to a taxi driver asking, please, can you put the mask on? And some of them would have it. A lot of them didn't even have it. They would cancel my request, because usually I use apps like Uber or Yandex Taxi. And yeah, it was a nightmare. Like, Then, whenever I got into the car, they reluctantly put the mask on. Then I would have to have a very long conversation with them. And just trying to, like, appeal on a human level, just to say, look, like, I don't know, this is dangerous. Why should we risk? I mean, after all, it's just a piece of cloth. It's so easy to put on. It really is not something extraordinary that people are asking from you to do. I got emotional. But yeah, they would be like, but it doesn't exist. Or like all the reasons that I just listed before. And I would be like, oh my God. So I started to come up with something more radical. I would just say, you know, where I come from, we get 600 euros fine. And then suddenly they become interested and they're like, so where do you live? And then we have a conversation. So in a way, I started to show off like that I live in Spain, but also trying to bring a different perspective, because when they just know that I'm a Russian girl, they have no interest. They think I'm stupid because I want to wear a mask, and they don't really take my opinion into account. The fact that I'm also a client and paying for the service, forget it, doesn't matter. When I arrived to Russia, I got my first shot, and I had quite a rise of the temperature. I had a very sore arm. My temperature was not as bad, like it never actually reached 38, but it was 37.5, 37.6, and then it lasted for the whole week. Even though I felt fine, like I even felt like running or doing exercise, whenever I checked my temperature, it was still showing 37.2. But then it kind of made me feel better, almost better, having some after effects after the shot, because that means that something was going on in my body, like it was resisting COVID or creating antibodies. So I figured out that was normal. And in the hospital, they also told me, yes, that's totally normal. Some people have temperatures that rise up to 40. After my second shot, I was expecting I would feel worse than after the first shot. I did it in 20 days and actually I was completely fine. Like I had a sore arm again and it actually hurts to sleep on it for some nights, but it was totally fine and I didn't even have a temperature. And I think the second day after I got my second shot, I told my mom, let's go and run on the stadium. And she said, come on, you have to rest. You just got vaccinated. Are you okay? And I said, yeah, now that I was chipped by Bill Gates, I can do whatever I want. Okay, that was a bad joke. And for anyone who doesn't know, there is a conspiracy theory that the whole COVID thing was created by Bill Gates because he wants to chip all the people in this world. And I wonder how it looks though, like in your head, how do you imagine like people who are sitting at home or who get vaccinated? Does Bill Gates put a chip during the vaccine, or so the chip is liquid, or like how does it work? Explain it someone to me in comments, maybe you can understand, because as much as I find this theory interesting, I really don't get any logic behind it. But I guess this is whole Russian versus Western Cold War fight, and again, it's hard to avoid politics here, and I'm not really gonna go into that. Another crazy theory that I heard of is that it's dangerous to do a vaccine, especially for women, because you can become infertile. And before I did my first shot, that was a big concern for me. I want to be a mother one day, and I was considering and reading and thinking. And the truth is, there is no evidence of such thing. There were cases where women were vaccinated and then later they got pregnant and had babies. But of course, you never know. When the vaccine is being tested for at least 2 years, anything can come up, and maybe we will hear about something on the news. I hope not. I hope it all goes well. But I just want to stress that I don't know how the vaccine works. It was a certain risk. We all have to take certain risks. But I think for me, the whole story with COVID is also about empathy, because it shows that it's not just about you. It would be interesting if it was just about you, but it's not. It's actually about people around you. You can change the situation. You can wear a mask. You can hold the distance. You can wash your hands. Like, there are certain rules and recommendations that are out there, and then it's your choice if you follow it or not. But when I think about holding the distance or wearing a mask, I first of all think not about myself. I really think about some 80-year-old grandma or grandpa who can be near me, and then I might be having COVID without knowing it, and that I can infect them. And I just don't think it's fair to do to anyone. And I don't want to live all my life thinking that what if I have infected someone. I think it is about being human and humanity for me. So that's why being in Russia was so difficult. Like, it triggered anger in me, because whenever I tried to speak to people, it obviously didn't work, and at some point I just gave up, and now I came back, and I'm feeling way happier here, where people actually follow the rules. But if you're still watching this video, I'm just asking you, it's so easy to wear. Like, it's, yes, of course it might make your skin bad, which happens to me with like my acne and everything that happens here, but I think the cost of all of it is someone's life, and I really do believe that it's important and it's possible to follow the rules. And if the scientists tell us in a month that masks are not necessary, that holding a distance is not necessary, or there are some other new things and new facts that we learn, well, let it be. Then we change our strategy. But I like the idea when people act together, and I think in this difficult situation, it's really important that you're not rebellious. Like, I'm a rebellious person, but I don't see a point being rebellious. I want for our community to get better. I want all of us to get back to normal life. And if we're resisting it, if we're neglecting it, if we don't care about older generation as well as younger generation, or anyone with diabetes, cancer, you know, all the other conditions, well, this is for me very sad. So I hope we'll get better. I hope we take care of each other and of ourselves. Thank you for watching this vlog. Share your opinions in the comments and subscribe to my vlog if you like what I just said. Yoko Piquette.